Humanistic management is the protection of dignity and the promotion of well-being. Dignity is the notion of universal inherent value. Like, we are precious in itself, unique, priceless.
Dignity is about our inherent value and worth. And I think it would be easy to see that. The other part of it, of the definition, is about our inherent vulnerability. Because just as we are vulnerable, human beings are vulnerable to physical injuries, where our dignity is also vulnerable to attack.
We are oftentimes not seeing ourselves as intrinsically valuable. We are lapsing and collapsing something in terms of our value in the world as something that shows up in terms of a car, big house, status, power, wealth, all of these kind of traditional signifiers of you have made it. You have made it in the context of what we call an economistic story of success, that yes, you are wealthy, you're powerful, you're seen as somebody important. And in the context of a more humanistic interpretation of that, it's moving away from this wealth, status, and power notion as success to well-being. Are you fundamentally self-expressed? Are you happy? Are you living a life where you truly feel you're flourishing? You are flourishing and people around you are flourishing. Is there the space for that? And that's a more global humanity scope. We have a problem of the workplace in itself, in where oftentimes managers are learning to dehumanize. We have that in the army, where it's almost like a prerequisite that you dehumanize people.
Yeah, I was known as 217 for the first 20 years of my career. I wasn't a person, I was a number, and I had to rate that on a job.
Barry Waymiller has discovered something very fundamental about this idea of purpose, that the purpose does not have to be rooted in the product. Our purpose is our people, as it is expressed at Barry Waymiller, is an extremely powerful one. Right? People are always important. People matter.
I met people over the past 2 days who were genuinely interested to listen to the ideas of others. I recently heard probably one of the best leadership spokespeople, a guy by the name of Bob Gaylor, talk. And he said, do not confuse humility with meekness. He said, humility is being open to the ideas of others.
Imagine a world in which leaders learned how to listen to their people. What if we chose leaders on their ability, based on their ability to listen, not just talk? What if listening became the norm in our organizations and not just the exception?
We oftentimes tend to dehumanize, not because we want to, but because we think we have to, that is what is professional. Mm-hmm. Tom Friedman from the New York Times said, there's no poverty of money in this world. There's a poverty of dignity. People want to be part of a tribe, the drive to bond. They want to be part of something that's part of their dignity. If they don't feel like they're part of a community, they're not feeling fundamentally human.
This world that I imagine is 100% possible. What you have is a blueprint. One other company, regardless of their size and regardless of their industry, will see it and say, that's interesting. And it won't be perfect, and it won't be easy, and it won't be difficult, but they'll give it a try. And then they'll tell another company, and they'll give it a try, and then they'll give it a try, and then they'll give it a try. And all of a sudden you get 100 or 1,000 companies that move on the exact same pace and the exact same scale that it happened internally.
The tragedy is that we don't think we can change anything about it. We can choose life, we can choose dignity, we can choose flourishing. And that just requires us to rethink. To think differently, act differently, be differently. That's the real possibilities. Like, we can be different, joyful, kind, and have enough. And yeah, mic drop.